The Active Learning Initiative started in 2012 now, back as a small initiative in the College of Arts and Sciences. And the intention was to transform the teaching culture in the largest lecture courses. You know, I had lectured for many years the way I had been taught, standing in front of a big classroom and talking to them. And I was told that, you know, there are much more effective ways of doing this, and, you know, struggled for a semester to transform the material. It was clear from the first moment of teaching this way that it was infinitely better. I remember the classroom becoming alive, students talking, and it was just delightful. And it was clear from the first second that this was a really fantastic way to interact with students and to learn from them and to watch them learn.
One thing I really enjoyed was the polling questions. It's more of like a time for interaction. You get to sort of develop your thoughts more rather than just sitting there and passively taking the class. I think when you're talking to other people, you're getting ideas that you wouldn't have had naturally.
A lot of my other STEM classes is kind of like, here's the information, study it, take the test. This one, it was very different. It was work with your teammates, work through it, do these practice problems. If you have any questions, please feel free to email me.
When you're talking to somebody, if you don't understand it, either they'll help you or you'll remember that you didn't understand it, and then you'll go back and be like, oh, during this activity, I had no idea what was going on. I have to know it. So I think it also kind of creates that like sense of like urgency, and you understand what you don't understand.
Class time was dedicated to working with the people sitting at my table, checking in with the professor, checking in with TAs, stopping in the middle of class to share our answers with the rest of the class and kind of going forward.
If you tell a student what to look for or what to research, they may learn some aspects of the topic. But if you ask them to develop their own questions, they become curious and they start investigating and start engaging in scientific expert behavior.
I did feel more like a real scientist. Frustratingly, I felt more like a real scientist just because in all my physics courses, we're learning about the physics that other people have done, but this is the first time where I was able to look at something and say, I want to know how that works and solve it myself. That's how we get stuff like the Higgs boson and cool new discoveries. You know, people pushing the boundary by not knowing, but you know, wanting to know.
I took introductory field biology when I was a sophomore, and this class was the epitome of hands-on learning and a very transformative experience. I know not only for myself, but many of my friends and fellow classmates, essentially everything we do is really driven by the students, and we're able to collect our own data and do hands-on work, which is truly incredible, and I had never had the experience to do that before.
So much learning is theoretical, and you learn, you know, the concepts behind things, and that's good too, but it's really important to see, how does this apply in real life? What does it actually mean? What does it look like when I'm carrying it out?
So one really striking aspect of teaching in this way is that there is a very strong human connection between students and students as they work together, and then also instructors and students.
I quickly became friends with the people in that table. We would do the homeworks together. We would go to office hours together. We would coordinate times when all of us could go at the same time.
It forces you to make friends and like talk to people in the class. So when you are trying to study, you already have that kind of like safety net of being able to talk to people about it, and you feel more comfortable asking questions.
You can put your sort of abstract thoughts into a more concrete space. And then when you share that with other students, you sort of get this feedback that helps inform your own thoughts.
The group portion really made it more about how you could kind of perfect what you were doing, what the best solutions were. Interestingly, it took some of the pressure off, because as soon as you talked it through, you'd have a really good understanding of what you did right, what you did wrong, how you could avoid mistakes in the future, and it wasn't so much about the grades or the points.
Brilliant teachers have always known that this is a better way to teach. And the Active Learning Initiative has given them a platform to get everybody else on board, to share their tricks of the trade, and for junior teachers to learn from them.
Active learning methods that are employed by professors help students better understand the material and not just learn it to learn it. There's application and collaboration and true interest in what a student is learning when they're under that active learning mindset.